Hey guys, David here, Texas Horns football. Obviously coming off of a really tough Sunday yesterday with the news coming down really pretty early Sunday morning that Longhorn legend great Cedric Benson died tragically in the motorcycle accident around the Austin area late Saturday. So really tough past 24 hours, you know, for Longhorns fans, obviously players, former players, coaches, you know, everybody losing someone, you know, that of the impact that Cedric had on the program. You know, I haven't read a whole lot of other details on what actually happened. Multiple news sources say that there was also a woman that was a passenger on his motorcycle who also died in the wreck. Apparently, they hit a minivan that was pulling out. So, you know, I'm not here to report, you know, a bunch of details, but just wanted to put together a video just with my thoughts on Cedric and give you guys an opportunity to throw your comments, you know, down there as well. You know, your experiences, you know, watching him, you know, absolutely, without question, one of my all-time favorite Longhorns that I followed, you know, even in high school when he was at Midland Lee. I follow Texas high school football pretty closely, and, you know, watching, you know, that whole career of what he brought to Texas high school football, to the Texas Longhorns program. You know, I think that's what I'll remember him, you know, most about, is just what he gave of himself to Texas high school football, the Longhorns program, how he gave his body to, you know, a really violent position, and the way he played, and the way he, you know, just gave his all every game. And you could just see that in the way he ran and his attitude, I think, about the game. So, you know, and also was reading a lot about just what some other former teammates and current players and what Mac Brown was saying. He had some words also during the North Carolina press conference yesterday. So, thought about doing a video yesterday, but wanted to kind of give a day just to kind of gather thoughts and everything like that, and to just kind of get some more information about everything. But just crazy tragic, 36 years old, you know, and just kind of wanted to throw out just a few things about what I'll remember most about him and just what he gave to the program. And, you know, looking back at what he accomplished at Midland Lee, and just really unprecedented. You know, they were a powerhouse during, you know, during his time in the early, you know, late 90s, early 2000s. You know, 5 touchdowns and three straight state championship titles. 15 total touchdowns there, just crazy. You know, in high school, that's just performing and producing at the highest level possible against the greatest competition in the state of Texas, and that's who he was. That's what, you know, that's what he was relied on to be, and he always stepped up to be that guy. And I think in a lot of ways, Cedric was one of the last style of running backs of that just kind of bruiser, hard-nosed running backs that can just put a team away. You know, not that there aren't those types of running backs out there today, but I just don't think teams use running backs like that anymore. Cedric was the guy. He was the guy that you gave the ball to 250, 300 plus times a year to, you know, he was the number one guy. He would just absolutely put teams away in the fourth quarter. That's the way he played. He ran with a bad attitude. He was so incredibly tough. You know, Mac Brown even said that. He said something like, you know, we've coached a lot of, we coached a lot of tough players at Texas, but they none of them more tougher than Cedric Benson. And that's what I loved about watching him play and watching him run. He had a nose for the end zone. He stepped up when he needed to step up. He played banged up, especially toward the end of the season, but he was that type of guy that would just get stronger and stronger. You know, you just keep feeding him the ball and let him wear those defenses down, and that's what I loved about watching him play. You know, I think, you know, there's also, you know, looking back, it's cool to see just how big of an impact he made, you know, just in the history of college football too. He was one of only 9 running backs to rush for 1,000 yards in 4 straight seasons. And, you know, that's something that you really just don't see anymore. You know, number one, it's hard for teams to, you know, really just go with a guy, you know, a true number one running back who can just take that level of production and that level of pounding and the number of carries that high. You just don't see that anymore. And, you know, just also looking at the fact that a lot of running backs are out of there after their, you know, third season, just because, you know, they don't want to hang around and take more and more carries. And Cedric was a rare breed. He took a lot. He carried the ball a lot. He got a lot of touches through high school and college, a lot. You know, by the time he was drafted, you know, number 4 overall by the Bears in 2005, he had already had a lot of carries, a lot of pounding on his body, and he was that type of running back. That draft had a lot of good running backs. You know, if you remember Cadillac Williams and Ronnie Brown from Auburn, also drafted right up there with Cedric in that first round. And, you know, Cedric's time in the NFL, 8 seasons, and really didn't have the production that most people expected. He had about three years with Cincinnati there where he rushed for 1,000 yards 3 years in a row. I believe his best season was about 1,200 yards rushing. But, you know, made an impact, but, you know, never was that big star that a lot of people expected. You know, looking back, we know he never was really happy in Chicago and just never really found that footing to be that star. But, you know, in terms of, I think, memories from his time at Texas, obviously he finished number 2 all-time in rushing yards behind Ricky Williams, just the guy that he idolized. And I think, you know, when I picture Cedric, I always picture the dreadlocks, the visor. He always had that mischievous smile on his face, and just giving it his all, you know, hard-nosed football. And I was trying to think about just, you know, the memories that stood out to me as a player. And, you know, really it came down to 3 games that I kept thinking of. One was his junior year against Oklahoma State in Austin. Oklahoma State jumped out to a 4-touchdown lead at halftime. And you know, it was the biggest comeback in Texas history. In the second half, Cedric scored 4 touchdowns. He just absolutely took over the game. He had scored 1 touchdown in the first half, so he scored 5 that day. But Texas came back and scored 42 unanswered points in the second half to beat Oklahoma State. And Cedric accounted for 4 touchdowns in the second half alone. That game, I think, always stood out to me as how he was the answer. You know, really the offense was built around him, especially in his junior and senior year. Even in his junior year, sharing that offense with Roy Williams, B.J. Johnson, Sloan Thomas. I think Bo Scaife was still there at the time. And then that kind of ushered in the Vince Young era. In Cedric's junior and senior seasons was Vince Young's freshman and sophomore season. And then the another game that really stood out to me that I just remember I believe it was a senior season against Texas Tech. I just remember him just absolutely putting the game away in the second half in the fourth quarter. And I remember he had like bad turf burns on his forearm. In that game, you could just see the skin was kind of tearing off of his forearms, and I just remember, Cedric had those the flame tattoos on his forearms, kind of starting at his wrist and flaming up, and I just remember that tattoo on his forearm, and just some of his skin was just, torn off from the turf burns, but God, he just kept going. He just, just gets stronger as he gets more and more carries, even though his body's just getting beat up. And then the other game, obviously the 2004 Rose Bowl against Michigan, where, it was his last game as a senior, and he hurt his knee really early in the game. And actually, Mac Brown came out yesterday and referenced that game and said that he had hyperextended his knee on the first play and went to the sidelines, and they looked at it, and one of the team doctors advised him to sit out because he could jeopardize, his draft status, because he was a lock to be a first round pick, really a lock to probably be a top 10 pick, and this was just a few months before the draft. And Cedric, told him to just tape it up, and he wanted to go back out there and play, and he played the rest of the game, had about 70 yards, wasn't super effective, running the ball for the rest of the game, but he went out there and played. So those three games, I think, stand out to me. Definitely leave in the comments just kind of your memories of Cedric and what really stood out to you. Cedric wasn't without his off the field issues from time to time. He had his few, run-ins with the law down there in Austin, but I think overall, he was just that type of personality. He was just that type of guy that was gonna just do and take action, and just live life. I saw a short interview today with Ivan Williams. If you remember, Ivan Williams was running back kind of slash fullback, I believe a year older than Cedric, but they became really good friends and stayed good friends. Even after, after their college careers. And he had a quote that was, I thought, was pretty cool. He said that he said we lived and he lived 100 miles an hour, literally in every sense. He had a nose for truth. He was allergic to anything else. If it wasn't good, and if it wasn't truthful, and if it wasn't real, he wasn't about it. And I've heard other players talk about him like that he was just very, very direct. Just wasn't interested in being fake. He kind of, is who he is. And then I pulled together just a few posts from some former players on social media from yesterday. Just kind of seeing what their thoughts and words were. This one from Brian Arakpo. Said B, your Texas brothers are mourning heavy right now. Family, rest easy, bro. We all miss you. When I first got to UT, I wanted to be a legend, like what you, Vince Young, Derek Johnson, etc. were. This one from Selvin Young, running back Selvin Young, really kind of the starter after Benson. He said, when you face failure, people will stop believing in you. When you taste success, everyone will believe in you. You, on the other hand, didn't have that luxury. You have to believe in yourself, whether up or down. There is one you, and whatever the world is saying, you don't give up on that ever. In failure or success, you remain your cheerleader for life. Rest in peace, Cedric Benson. You made me cheer myself on through some tough ass times or life battles, then celebrated with me once I figured out how to do it. Love you, brother. BJ Johnson said, We have give Drake a big hug for me, referring to the former Longhorns coach that actually also passed away this week. Words can't express the hurt our Longhorn community is feeling at this moment. We'll miss our talks and laughs together. It was an honor to call you a teammate and friend. Love you. From Ricky Williams, I just learned that fellow Longhorn Cedric Benson has passed on to the other side. Rest in peace to one of the greatest to have played at the University of Texas. And then Roy Williams. My senior year in high school, Cedric was averaging 260 yards by halftime. We held him to 99 in the first half, which is still a lot, but not for him. Tell me how we ended up with the district rushing record of 369 yards at the end of the game. When you see greatness with your own eyes, you have to give credit where credit is due. Rivals 0-3 versus Lee, Midland Lee. Obviously, Roy Williams played for Odessa Permian, the big rivalry down there in West Texas, Permian versus Midland Lee. 0-3 versus Lee, thanks, Sid. I hope he saw my post about love. He didn't like or respond, but I hope he saw it. Love you, big homie. And then Mac Brown, I think this was his first kind of public response on Twitter. Saddened by the reports on passing of Cedric Benson. We've coached a lot of tough players, but none were tougher than Cedric. He was a true spirit. Our thoughts and prayers are with his friends and family on this sad day. And then just one more from Vince Young. He didn't really say much, but he left this really cool photo. He said, "No comment. Love you, brother. Cedric Benson, hook 'em." And obviously you've got Derek Johnson there in the middle standing, and then Cedric and Vince. And it looked like a cool little locker room scene, probably from Vince Young's freshman season there. So anyway, tough weekend, tough day, tough past 24 hours. You know, I think the more you just kind of think about it and the hours have kind of passed by, the sadder it gets. Longhorn Network had a really cool tribute video to Cedric, and just seeing all the responses from former players and current players and coaches and things like that has been cool to see. But super sad, and, you know, just really proud of what he gave to the program. You know, not just football, but just the school, the brand of Texas, the brand of Texas football, and just the effort that he gave, I think is the number one thing that will always stay with me with Cedric Benson. You know, if you could have an example of how to play the game, you know, he's absolutely in the highlight reel of how the game is supposed to be played. He did it the right way. And, you know, sad day. So, anyway, just want to throw that out there. You know, drop in the comments, your experiences with Cedric, what you'll remember about him. And, you know, share the video out. Get some more Longhorns fans on here. If you have any other cool videos that you've seen out there, definitely share them as well. Would love to check those out. Check those out too. All right, guys, we're out. Season's coming up soon, so we'll have some more out shortly. Hook 'em.